Hi, and welcome to this review of irrational numbers. Today we'll be reminded of what an irrational number is and look at where they fall on a number line. Let's get started. So first, what is an irrational number? It is easy to determine whether a number is rational or irrational based on the word itself. Look closely. The root word ratio tells us that these numbers can be written as a fraction. Rational numbers include all proper and improper fractions. Decimals that repeat or that terminate can be written as fractions, so they are considered rational. For example, 0.3 repeated can be expressed as the fraction 1/3, so it is a rational number. This diagram clearly shows that there is no overlap between the rational and irrational number sets. Another way of thinking about it is that irrational numbers are those that cannot be written as a fraction. A common example of an irrational number is the value derived from taking the square root of a non-perfect square. That may sound confusing, so let's look at a few examples to simplify the terminology. A perfect square is a number that can be rewritten as an integer multiplied by itself. For example, 4 equals 2 times 2. Or written another way, 4 equals 2 squared. This shows that 4 is a perfect square. Similarly, 16 can be rewritten as 4 times 4, or 4 squared. So 16 is also a perfect square. Because taking the square root of a perfect square results in an integer, it can be easily found on a number line. But how do we know where the value of the square root of 5 would fall on a number line? Well, the square root of 5 is roughly 2.236. So we can guess that it lands somewhere around here on the number line. Now let's say we had the square root of 31. Where would this value fall on the number line? 31 is not a perfect square. The closest perfect square that is less than 31 is 25, and the closest perfect square that is greater than 31 is 36. The square roots of 25 and 36 are 5 and 6 respectively, so we know we can place the square root of 31 somewhere in between. If we calculate the square root of 31, we indeed get 5.567, so we can estimate that it falls halfway between 5 and 6. There are actually some famous irrational numbers that you may have seen before. Pi, for example, is a non-repeating decimal that goes on for infinity every time, for every circle. When calculating with pi, a common estimate is 3.14159, or the fraction 22 over 7. Phi is another irrational number that can at best be mathematically approximated. The general estimation is the value 1.618, which is used in visual arts, architecture, and design applications. The math constant E is seen frequently in math and is estimated with the value of 2.71828. This special irrational number is sometimes referred to as Euler's number, to credit the Swiss mathematician Leonard Euler. Formulas dealing with natural logs, complex numbers, and advanced concepts in calculus all use this important irrational number. So as you can see, irrational numbers are unique in that they cannot be expressed fully as fractions, but they can be visualized on a number line with rational numbers by using approximations. Thanks for watching, and happy studying!